Welcome back. I hope you stay tuned. That previous match was not only on Oregon of all things, but it was also quite an interesting, to say the least, a 7-4 outcome from the side of, I forgot, let me go and check, from the side of Kudo. And cool guys, well, though they did try, it was not enough. As we're waiting on the last player, let me give you a bit of an information run through on what we're going to be seeing currently. It's going to be a BO1 yet again, Chillwagon, which is currently on the second place, going up against Firebird Esports, which are on the 7th. Also, just the standings have changed since Kudo did actually manage to win. Chillwagon still on 2nd, Blue Jays Talons on 3rd. Kudo actually managed to get on 5th. Cool Guys Esports got bumped down a bit to the 6th, and so did Firebirds Esports, which are on 7th currently, used to be 6th. And Blue Jay Ventus, which were on 7th, but now are 8th. So that's quite an interesting standing we have there. But yeah, Chillwagon facing off against Firebird Esports. I casted both of these teams once, I do believe. But, you know what map it is, guys? It's going to be the one and only Oregon for match number 2. The presence, here I come. As, of course, adding...
I don't want to cast this.
You don't want to? You don't
Oregon.
Have a choice anymore.
I don't... No, it's Oregon. Yeah, I'm going to bully Chris and Golanis for actually choosing Oregon. I don't
This is already enough of a torture chamber for me just watching this map. But yeah, to be honest...
I'm sorry, what did you say? Like, before the entire stream even started, what did you say? Oregon is the best map to play on and cast. Do I recall that correctly?
I have no clue what you mean. It's probably just you, like, mishearing something, definitely.
Okay, I'll remember this. I'll remember this. Watch yourself, mate. Watch yourself.
I'll wash myself later, thank you very much. But... with that in mind, one of the teams is ready. We just need a confirmation from the side of Firebird. As, of course, going into Oregon will be... to be honest, I'm just going to expect the same bands. I'm going to say Azami, Mira, Flores, and good old Maverick. I'm just going to predict it right now. Both of the teams are ready. So, without further ado, let's not waste time. And let's hop into the match. Now... who do you think the map's bands, well, not the map bands, the operator's bands would be the same?
The same bands. Like, Floss, either Maverick or Thatcher, or Usa,
yeah.
Mira, and either Valkyrie or Azami. Is my guess.
Fair enough. You know, I mean, it is quite default as... let's hope we get some exciting things. Dokubi. Well, we're both wrong as Dokubi gets taken out. Which, to be honest, I'm not surprised about with her EMP impact being added. She has been quite strong. Not only did she have intel, and, I mean, not too bad of a gun. The only thing that was keeping her from being actually played a lot was that Tekken Gear gadget, which, well, we have it here, but she's already banned. And the second one coming in is going to be Nook. Yet again, we are wrong. Already bringing some excitement to the match. Nook being quite strong earlier into the round, actually late into the round earlier as well, just in case you do want to keep that Nook off. She can come into your site and you wouldn't even hear her at this point. Like, it's just impossible. And well,
yeah, there's something wrong. Okay.
We wouldn't be too far off. I got one right, since right now the only one that needs to be banned is just, who was it? Was it... I was going to say Clash for a second, but that would be...
was it Azami? Yeah.
It was Azami, yes.
Maybe Valkyrie or Azami. Oh, there's the Valkyrie, okay.
There's the Valkyrie.
2 out of 4, that's actually not bad.
But yeah, very nice. I mean, Chillwagon starting on defense, and of course Firebird on attack. We're going to see who can do the better on each of these roles, as they are going to present that to us. And yeah, interesting bands. And we've been seeing not as much of the dynamic duo type playstyle from the side of just competitive, you know, the Thatcher Cade band. Now we've been seeing a lot more variations, which is actually very nice to see. You know, there's improvement. For a second, I got jump scared by that dog skin. I mean, that's just that's kind of like nightmare fuel for me. But yeah, going into Oregon upstairs, we're going You know what's the interesting thing I just spotted on the defensive side? We have the French boys joining us. It's going to be Doc and Rook. It seems like these guys are pretty confident in not getting headshot, nor are they not confident in gunfights. So it's going to be quite interesting to see. So with that ahead, I mean, what do you think Doc and Rook could really be like? Just can stand out for?
10 seconds to go. They got the boss. I just have realized why are they getting brought in this round.
Oh no, don't tell me.
Rook got the self-revive buff and Rook now heals 200.
Oh well, well. Oh my god, it actually almost happened. The Thatcher did actually manage to trade out some HP, to be honest. But Spawn Peaks, holy, first round we... We barely got in, and Doc with the bailiff. What have I been missing out on?
Yep,
I know, but
yep, another weapon, indeed. These boss are cancer. Expect them to be brought in the game. Doc now heals 200 HP, has a bailiff, and something else. I forgot what it is. Plus, Rook has a self revive, and. What was that? Yeah, Rook has self-revive, that's it.
With the Rook, it's been actually being brought up since... for quite a while. But I feel like it's a good thing to add some nerfs to very strong operators, like Maverick with the nade. Maybe bring back, or bring in, some operators with some buffs, like, of course, Rook and Doc. And the first kills of... the match are going to be brought out as Chris the Thatcher, quite an unfortunate pick, is going to be getting taken. Now Daniel with another one of his own onto Mark. It's going to be the Zofia, a 5v3 situation. The 5v2 getting turned on by Jedi. He's only Jedi, I believe. And Dexir going to be taken out. Not a flawless run for Joe Wagon so early on, as it is a 4v2 turned on to a 4v1. And again, Daniel not too bad at all. And of course, the shotgun comes in around the corner, and a nice, not so nice, but you know, a good old teabag from the side of the defensive as they get the first round. It's going to be Chill Wagon with quite a starter right there. And, well, is this not turning out? You know, you always expect this to be a bit more of a boring map. You always expect to see the same. Is this the day of us getting just proven wrong, the casters? I mean, come on, spawn peeking, that's absolutely fantastic. So let's hope we can see a bit more new things as we go into the downstairs site.
Oh! Rook and Doc again.
They're French.
They haven't done really anything last round, but hey, maybe now. Is it Dexer or Dexir?
I'm gonna call him Dexter. There's no two eyes.
Dexter is running that Melusi, which I love to see, partially because I was a Melusi main. Now I don't really play Siege. That's the difference. I just had enough.
Attackers are moving.
I love to cast
it
though.
Bomb and defuse it.
Especially with you.
Oh. Don't make me blush.
But,
yeah. I mean, Siege kind of give up on it as well. Maybe play with friends, just because Ryan is always, tough to be seen.
Up a diversion.
But yeah.
It's just fun anymore, you know.
Mm-hmm.
You go into a casual and get either spin-botted or try-harded by X-Diamond.
Because why not?
Because this is Rainbow Six Siege.
Welcome.
You wanna have fun? Oh hell no.
Wrong place. So yeah. Just not too much has been done. So Chill Wagon with the French boys, it's quite interesting. You know, at least they're bringing out some operators that are not commonly seen, and not even Heartbreak Denial is to be seen. The OSAC is starting to come in. Quite a menacing stare from the side of Firebird Esports, as no actual kills have been dropped, but it seems like we're going in that direction, as of course it's gonna be the OSA Lunar taking some damage himself on the peak of death, just a far away, and he'll be finished off with 1:40 on the clock. We're just gonna have to see how this ends up. So, yeah, just run us through this, everyone.
This is, well, first of all, don't get the kill. That is Rich taking down. Then comes Zaxa with the MP5 headshot. So that is Ying taking care of. So that is the insult of Fiber Esports taking care of. So, we still have an Ashe, we still have a Hibana, we still have an Osa on the hands of Firebird. Both of the defenders, everyone's alive now. Chris has been taken down by the Rook. Now, Jetty gets another kill. That is Funo with a headshot. It is all down to Golanis. Now he gets one. What? There's a team kill. That is Jetty getting the kill on. Who was it? Maybe Jaeger. I have no clue at this point. All I know is that don't be confused if I refer to Lovnar as Golanis, because that is his more known name. I'll say it like that.
He's, all right.
Yeah, that's his name on Discord, on Twitch, on everything.
Well, so yeah. There we have it, just so no confusion is to be had. But yeah, I mean, it was an interesting match. The Freezer did come down for the Osa to be standing last, and while though it was quite difficult for the defending side to fend it off, I mean, the aggression, actually for the attacking side to fend it off, the aggression there was absolutely insane, even a team kill. We're going on to round 3, and well, what do I see from Jetty, and I'll just call him Hadge, I'm not gonna say a name for 3 minutes straight. It's gonna be the French boys coming out. Hajabuza Jakuza.
He's not Hungarian, but the Hungarian way to say that would be Hajabuza Jakuza.
Hajabuza Jakuza. Alright.
Oh, what the fuck? Hello?
Hello.
Say Kurtoskolac.
Huh?
Kurtoskolac. You're secretly Hungarian, or you're not telling me something?
I do come from Europe, so I'm one of the Balkan countries.
I know because you told me.
Well, then there you go. I guess we can put 2 and 2 together and... my goodness.
Jesus Christ. No. No. Well, that is kind of taken now. I guess that's an ESO of the board.
Man, the damage passed down to Chillwagon by the enemy team. It seems like doing the job for them right there. As Yuno starts to get a bit into the breach, but the aggression comes out. I mean, the castle getting a kill. Hayabakuza?
Let's go Haya.
Alright, Haya getting the kill, but of course not being taken out himself. Of course, the castle taking quite a lot of damage, and there you see it. There you saw that 200 HP. The castle went from almost zero back to full HP. Although it did get dropped quite quickly, the dock repaired it almost instantly. A nice shot onto Daniel by the Sophia player, but it's a 4v1 situation. Will he be able to clutch it out? No, he will be not doing that.
Did you see that? Oh, what the hell? That was a nice. That was actually a nice shot.
It was.
Yes. Wanna talk about what the next map will be like after this match?
So, anyways, going on to round number 4, we're going to be seeing the Doc and Rook combo yet again, and also a Warden in play, so quite interesting, and just on the attacking side, they're having a bit of a rough time with Chillwagon just being this aggressive. Mention that one more time, and I will do absolutely nothing about it, because I can't, we're in different countries.
Because I can't. For me, would be like, say that one more time, and I will, and you just say, you will do nothing because you can't. I would be like,
wanna bet?
Yeah, I bet 2 Robux.
So, next map will be our beloved Oregon.
Yeah, the final match is gonna be Oregon as well, so, thankfully, Yahoo's not gonna be did the torture with me, but I hope I will be seen.
No, I'm not.
It's Goral, I believe, who's gonna be casting.
And you will stay here suffering in Oregon.
Hey, to be honest, these two matches that are being brought upon us, even if it is Oregon, it is quite exciting, especially
It's not because not being exciting, it's just Oregon. Again, thrice in a row.
That is kind of a punishment on its own, to be honest.
You did something bad, now Trip and the god himself will punish you.
Because this is my trial, guys. And of course, Hanya with another kill onto Martin. What a shot. He takes some damage himself, but of course not going to be getting taken out. I mean, I think Doc is right now pretty tempted to just shoot that Doc Sim through three walls, because why not? I mean, they're built different, it seems like. And of course, there he goes. Will he be able... For a second, I was going to suggest maybe a drone hole shot, but not as much. Like, even a whole new rotation just to get it in. And of course, the shots come in. And of course, there goes Aya with another kill. The MP5 in hand, absolutely unstoppable. And both of their HPs are just put back to like
this
nothing happened.
This is broken. This is absolutely not okay.
I call foul. This is not okay, Siege. And while Pan's gonna be getting shot down by the one and only L85 user, Denyo with the SMG 11 getting taken, actually taking down Lunar with, of course, Ayana being there. So no flawless round just yet, but it seems like Joe Wagon is back to their good old place of, I guess you could say, just their, comfortable space there, I'll say it like that. And back to the names. Krapkovichki Drip.
Krapkovichki. Whee!
I don't want to call him Krap, so I'll call him Drip.
it's like at the cast before, we called Blue Jays BJs. And we had Jesus. We have the BJs. We have Crap.
Let's not call him Crap. He probably doesn't give to.
It's not because of that. It's Krapkovitsky. Krapkovitsky.
Yeah.
I guess so. Krapkovitsky.
Whatever it may be, we'll call him Drip for short. Bringing it all. Let's call him Jaeger. I don't. Just refer to him as Drip, and we'll be fine. We won't get into any trouble. We would not.
Drip has Drip.
If you want, it would be quite ironic. But round number five, we're going downstairs. And what happened downstairs last time? What do you think good old Firebird Esports could improve right here?
Not push alone with an answer. Maybe. That's another good. That's one good thing. Because the Ursa was all alone inside Frieza. Tower got absolutely eradicated. Room play by the two Frenchmen were absolutely insane. So maybe room clear. Flank watch, maybe bring in a Nomad or a Gridlock.
5 seconds to insertion.
Don't push alone with an Ursa, possibly like the Lion going with the Ursa or Maverick. Maverick going with the Yana. Ash switches to Gridlock. Godanis and Martin will be going inside Frieza, and Huno, the Ash who should have switched to Gridlock, takes a huge ton of damage from what?
Spawn Beak. We've been seeing it quite a lot from the side of Joe Wagon. They're being quite comfortable. And you know what? Confidence, having too much of it can be a bit of a disease, you could call it, a virus. But you know what? If it can work out for your favor, you always love to have it. And I mean, it's working out here. Although Firebird is trying their best, Dexter is going to be coming in quite heated at Kaz as the Yana player gets taken out. Still bunker very contested. And you know, I was going to say there's potential for a team kill right there. Almost a shot. Oh my goodness, this Osa and Lion really do have some sort of like magnetic connectivity. As there, yet again, it was a bullet or two against another team kill, which is very unfortunate. And Huno does actually get taken out with the Osa Lunar, both down but not fully out. Dexter with a nice pistol finishing kill. And well, the Rudy won't be there for too long as Lion takes her out. The smoke kill, joined by the SMG 11, is going to be Denio with a double onto the side of Firebird. And Lion is right now alone. A 1v4 situation. A very nice shot onto the blue stairs. Everyone's running out. Just absolute mad lads trying to contest it. I mean, they all want the nice finishing kill. They all want to see how well they did. But yeah, it's... You know, all of these rounds, it seems like Chillwagon always had this huge, had the potential, not the potential, just this huge advantage. It was always a 1v X situation for the side of Firebird, which is quite hard to pull through. Oh, he's still with us?
This is, like, I'm just
shocked?
Not shocked. I'm surprised, but not shocked. That this is this much of a bloodbath. Because no matter how you look at it, it is 5-0 for Chillwagon. And
attackers need to locate and defuse bombs.
Wait, requesting more to crash the match?
Yeah, that's... I mean, this is just proving their point of what Siege is slowly...
Ubisoft
interaction, but they do make good Assassin's Creed games. At least they did. I absolutely love most of the Assassin's Creed games. Go from Origins down, including it. Chef's kiss.
Yep, indeed. What was your favorite, actually?
10 seconds remaining. I loved 3, but I have to say Black Flag is my favorite, definitely. So good. It's just
Black Flag is by far the best.
Attackers are heading out to defuse a bomb.
I do like Origins though, because you can actually interact with animals and stuff like that. Like, that's one of the parts.
Martin! Finally, he gets a kill. It is Martin coming in with the spawn peak. That is it. Not spawn peak. Sorry, the spawn peak. Oh,
denial, I guess. Frag.
Somewhat along the lines of that. It is the dog being taken down. Possibly the most useful operator in the entire enemy lineup as of right now. That is an attacker being taken down. That is Kuno. But he gets, gets refragged. That is Kaz getting in with a double kill. That is the Rook and the Capcan being taken down. Dexa is, well, not too much with HP. He drops, he gets one nice headshot, but it is Martin who does get the headshot. 1v3 for Dexa. Maybe this will be either a 6-0 or a 5-1, and it will be a 5-1 split. Why do I feel like I'm... Well, I have deja vu.
Deja vu, eh?
Mm-hmm.
How so? From just a dream?
Lost split was 5-1. Lost match.
Oh, yeah, you are correct. But you know, the difference is the approach being taken on from these two teams is completely different. There was just one round where Firebird went completely aggressive and actually managed to win because of it. And the other rounds actually played a lot more defensively, as Chillwagon, they've just been going at it constantly, which, I mean, if it's working out for them, I guess. And Chillwagon is on attack, and just look at the loadout. Look at what that monster is. That absolute train of wreckage. You are correct. It is going to be a blitz.
Attackers need to locate and defuse.
They may have been aggressive on defense, but how aggressive is Chillwagon on attack?
I'm sorry, that's right now I'm raping. What the hell is that blitz sense combo?
Refraction. Yep.
The hell is that?
The question you just asked kind of reminds me of, you ever saw the Siege meme? It's a smoke asking every operator what's in the canister. What's in the canister?
Oh yeah, that's what wrong. I love it.
It's absolutely great. 5 seconds that's what kind of made you sound like. What's in the canister? Details.
My favorite was what's in the canister? And it was like Sophia's son. And do you know anything about my sister? It's best you don't ask.
That was by far the best.
Perfection. Whoever made that meme, absolute mad legend in my books.
They deserve an award from Ubisoft themselves.
They do. They deserve like a trophy of just good meme. That's all.
Additional tickets, at least.
Yeah. They should be the caster.
Yeah. Oh hell yeah. And then they like a smoke bomb before. What's in the canister? Wrong.
What's in the canister? Come back. Right.
Just like casually 1v5s.
Yeah.
Down and Jesus Christ, what is happening?
Not even healing.
Oh, Jesus is playing for another team. That's one thing for sure.
Wow.
What a shot. Did you see that?
Indeed, I did. It was very nasty. I mean, the bunk bed player couldn't even. I mean, to be honest, the outside of the mean window, it was kind of unreactable, but it worked out. And Chewagon, I mean, they're looking at quite a tough situation. And even then, I'm actually quite surprised. You could even say shocked that Vibrate themselves is actually playing the duo, the French duo. Of course, Doc and Rook. So, I mean, the buff does seem to be...
Mumifor. It is Hoya. The mile-long name guy.
The mile-long name guy, is that what you want to call him?
Why am I...
I don't know. Can you tell me what's in the canister?
I don't know, all I know is that I'm bleeding.
Wrong.
What?
But... You try and get that sorted out, I'll cover it for you. Back to a 1v3. It's going to be Haya with another quite a stressful situation here. Chewagon, they managed to be pretty aggressive on defense, but although they did manage to pull that on attack as well, it doesn't seem to be working out for them too well. 20 seconds on the clock. What will the Sienna player do? Not nades. Drone is too late. And well, it seems like it's going to be going to the side of Firebirds. A 5-2 seems to be going on a bit of a comeback right now as Kaz with the TCSG, a beautiful shot onto the top of White Stairs. And well, not too bad. I mean, there's some potential for a bit of a comeback, but we'll see if they can manage through. I mean, back again to the Blitz. Chewagon is not chilling out. See that pun? That joke, whatever you want to call it. They're just going at it. And, you know, ironically, they call themselves the Chill Wagon, yet they have a very unchill-like Blitz play. Chill being the wagon, Blitz being the wagon, and of course, Chill is not them. They're absolutely insane, and that's what you love to see. And downstairs, this just seems like a perfect Russian opportunity. Hibana going for hatches. Lion is always useful, but the Blitz. It seems like Jetty is not going to be giving up on that wall. Holy. Do you have anything to comment on that?
10 seconds
to go. Humanity is ready for extinction. That is the only thing I gotta say to that.
Attackers are moving to
Jesus
bomb.
Christ. Jackal. Blitz. Oh no.
This will be nice.
Off to a great start, I see. Blitz can, I guess, to some extent be used for taking, I guess, just the playing field out very quickly or just covering ground really fast.
Will they use it for that?
It's working out for now.
Well, for now, and they're gonna fucking rush down Frieza.
If it works. I don't know what to tell.
What do you mean, if it works? It's a walking shield with a flashbang mounted on it. How the hell wouldn't it work?
I'm not doubting the power.
You can't argue with that.
No, huh? I can't. You're right, but... You know... if it manages to work, it'd be quite surprising. Well, gotta catch them all. It's gonna be Yeti taking a lot of damage from Lunar. That impact is quite resourceful when you come to think of it, when it comes to damage, especially shield ops. Haya even trying to, you know, assist him from the hatch. I was assuming there was going to be a team kill there, but it seemed like they're not going for main breach and breaches as much as expected. The Hibana are still through hatches, though. I guess you can count that as the main breach here. But, you know, not focusing on that, it seems like they're just trying to get these early picks off so they can start going at it against the opposing team. Dexter taking some damage himself, but not going down without a fight. He's going to be taken out. You know, the Oryx, the goat, being taken out quite surprisingly. The pillar player pushes up, and wow, that timing unfortunate. As, of course, the Blitz drops down, flushes the Rook, and actually almost hip fires him, but gets taken out as Dexter with another kill. It's going to be a 5v, actually a 4v3 situation. The smokes are starting to slowly get released. As we're down to the last minute, and who is happening?
Flashbangs are going in from the Hibana. Chris is trying to hold his ground as good as he can. Daxa has been injured by Martin. Oh! Denio has also been injured. Chris, will he hold his ground? No, this is a double kill for Drift. And it is a point for Chillwagon.
Oh! The Bane. It's all there. A 6-2 score for Chillwagon that puts the amazing pressure of having to win 4 rounds in a row against the team that has been quite aggressive. Not only that, but has been shutting off entire plans of Firebird right now. I mean, Firebird, 2 of the rounds, they did actually really well. But Chillwagon, most of these rounds, they didn't allow any refrags. And even if that happened, they would just punch back tenfold. I mean, absolute shutdown potential. Although it is an interesting way to go about it with the Blitz, with the Rushes, with the Spawn Peaks, the French boys. But, you know, it's working out, so we can't say much. If it works, it works. And also a beautiful kill from the end of Drip right there. And even the kills are kind of evened out, you know. You have 7-5, 6-7, 8, just not too bad. Same could be said for Firebird, but not really. Martin remaining. Seems to be joined by Kaz on the, I guess, the frag side of this match, as the others don't seem to participate as well. Just like mentioned earlier, they kind of get shut down.
You know what? I just... This match is killing my brain cells.
You have brain cells after the first couple of rounds? I've already lost mine. I'm starting to deteriorate.
I had 4, now I have 2.5.
I'm going into the miners, baby. Profit.
Oh, hell yeah.
I don't know why we're acting like this is good for health.
It's not. It never was. No! Who know? SMG-12! Headshot spawn peak. Damn.
Holy. He is not liking the way of performance. And
what? Oh, no, second.
Oh, whoa.
Okay, he's getting another one. Okay, that is the Warden taking down. That is Daxa actually getting the kill on the Warden. 2-4 for Chillwagon.
The turns seem to have tabled. As of course, a 2v4 is.
Yeah, say that again. I dare you.
The turns have tabled.
What? Why?
This is already a cursed enough match. I need to cast 3 matches of war. I did mention my brain cells is going into the miners, but Dexter right now getting challenged, gets taken out. Not too bad. I mean, it's going to be a 1v4 situation, meeting still contested by the defenders, and it seems like it's going to be a kill from the Hibana. 1 minute and 15 on the clock. Will she be able to fulfill and maybe possibly finish this painful match of Oregon as we're down the last minute? And
actually, I think he will be.
You think he will? All right, we'll see. It's not impossible to say the least.
If he drops, he won't, but if he goes down like Freezer route, or Tostas.
Do you have some sort of team speak with him?
No.
I
what the fuck?
Trippin'. He's hacking.
I can create a moss. I can create the most foil for you. I don't care. Jesus Christ.
Do it exactly as you said.
This is telepathy.
Imagine it actually works out. Oh no. Don't.
Why?
This is being very silent, everybody. This is 15 seconds remaining.
10 seconds to go.
I mean, 10 seconds on the clock. But well, to be honest, I was actually expecting it to happen, and I was about to report you to
the
federal police of Trippin, but sadly, that's not going to be happening.
Actually, who I would be happening is not Chillwagon. It would be Firebird, since they are my friends, but. But I don't help anyone. Like, that is telepathy. What? I'm suspicious.
Oh, I guess the first signs of mutants and superheroes coming into action is going to be in Rainbow Six Siege. That would be depressing. If the first type of superpower was discovered in Rainbow Six Siege or something like that, like a really depressing dying game, a T4 cast out of everything, that would be like kind of sad if you ask me, but
Siege is playing.
This is talent
from 400,000 to 8 million.
You know, it may be T4, but this is talent league, the best.
Yeah, talent league is the best.
This is quality. This is quality, unlike can't
yeah,
say anything.
You mean I mean it's still T4. If you think about it, I don't say this as a degrading way. Like, in not a fucking like pro league match. No, not a CL match at least. No, not even nationals. It's tier 4.
Look, I feel like it's sad enough that it happened on Siege already. I feel like that's enough of a low point.
But it's sad enough that Siege.
Yeah, but of course, Daniel with a lunar kill, another one dropped, but it's not going to be for the side of Chillwagon, as a 4v4 is compensated, and of course, Daniel himself, the man who took out the smoke, will be getting taken out. The zombie seems to be coming into play, and Thermite's starting to take a bit of kick damage, it seems like. Is that going to be the smoke in play? And quickly, smoke's dead, this makes sense.
That's Kate.
Yeah, getting a bit zapped by the Cade, of course. We can already assume that's for the timing, just because, well, you don't want to be too slow on that. As Haya gets a kill onto the Cade, he got a bit of vengeance for that claw, as a very nasty shot onto the gaming window. That HP gets completely revived as Thermite gets taken out. A 2v3 situation. Daxer right now quite in a dangerous spot himself. No doc to heal him, sadly. Will he be able to get a bit of bit of that blood lapse back? Not too much, as Martin gets another kill. He also jumps in, but it will not be enough, as Firebird gets their fourth round, looking making them like a 6-4. So Chillwagon seems to have been getting dropped a bit. I mean, slowly they're gonna have to start make at least a bit of a comeback if they even want to win today, because, well, Firebird is for sure right now getting absolutely hyped up. So come back, it's not impossible. I'll say that the least.
They still have to win two rounds in a row to actually go to overtime. And if they even lose one.
Look at defense. Look at defense.
Defenders, protect your bombs from being defused by attackers.
Oh no, yeah, I'll kill you. I'll kill you after this, I swear.
Let's just comment on the Kaveru, but let's not threaten the players.
No,
that are...
let's leave her out of sight. She doesn't exist for now, as we're discussing
this. It's definitely something they haven't planned. And to be honest, I don't blame him. I feel like Kaveru in this position may be reasonable. Now, listen, just hear me out. Although she is sneaky, Maybe they're expecting Chillwagon not to drone as much, because while they seem to get into sight very quickly, they don't drone too much, but they just rush in. So Akavera actually, with her silence, and especially her maneuverability around things, and kind of a counter to aggression at times, can actually maybe work out. So we're going to have to see. I mean, Hyuno's playing it perfectly right now, sitting well and tight. I just recommend him maybe getting on cams, but not too bad, not too bad. I mean, the drones are coming in, just proving my entire thing wrong, which makes me kind of sad. But yeah, I mean, the attacking, look at how quick this is going. Not even half a minute, they're already contested. Tower, the breach should be going down quickly, as I mean, ground is being covered very quickly. Martin trying to challenge anyone, just, you know, a bit of a cheeky rappel, but gets taken out by Dexir. It's gonna be Zofia with the opening kill onto this round, making the man advantage seem to be on the side of Chillwagon. And of course, the Azami right there, I won't say it, but that will be a lot of damage on the impact. That the whole team, the second that damage was released, the whole team came out. They absolutely did not accept it, and it seems like that Zami is gonna be, well, she's gonna be a nuisance, to say the least. But I think she can just get ignored for a bit.
I'm just.
Oh my god! That was actually.
Oh, I thought it was the window.
Yeah, I thought it was.
That would have been such a nice shot. Okay. Why is the Kavira actually working?
Well, I guess I wasn't. I wasn't too far off. As a 1v2 gets transferred, the Kavira can put up a challenge, especially with that pistol being pink. Able to.
There's the pink coming in from the Kavira.
True. And the Azami is quite low. Oh, where will it be happening? Jetty with not only the HP advantage, but still time and intel to drone out everything he has. And it comes out. And he also has the gun advantage, if you ask me. I mean, the PDW9 is extremely strong. The impact comes through. Sahami is on the edge of her HP right now. She is extremely low. The diffuser dropped on the green hallway. It's down to the last 30 seconds. It all depends on this. I mean, Firebird right now could just lose this entire round based on this one wrong movement from the side of Zami. The fake plants are going to start coming in. And oh, the unfortunate drop. Instantly recovering as Chris makes to come back. Get shot, but doesn't finish the job. Will he be able to finish it now? Yes, he will, as the defenders will be going on to round number 12. Oh, that was so stressful. Oh my goodness. Oh. I to be honest, I was kind of about to. I was about to make a poopy. But yeah. Ooh, it worked out. The Kavira actually did work out to some extent.
Hey. I'm just softly crying in myself.
No, it's ironic that you don't have your camera on, because I would love to see that.
Attackers need to locate and defuse bombs.
This match has degraded me so much that I just feel pretty good.
You'd think maybe, like very emotional things, like losing a chance to get into uni or something emotional. Oh, you have no idea what playing Goragon, actually casting Goragon for 3 matches straight is like. Especially when I
can Goragon to cast.
No, but jokes aside, of course. It's not that bad, but it's repetitive. And you can't. To be honest, I kind of like Goragon. Even casting it, it's not that big of a pain. It's just you're kind of used to it. But at least, you know, we can appreciate the teams for bringing something new, like Banning Flash. Chillwagon's absolute playstyle, which is just off the charts. A Kavera. I mean, all these things just align up nicely to make a good match. And, well, I've been having quite a fun time, so let's hope it continues as Chillwagon. They haven't taken their time out yet, so gonna have to see how that works out for them. I mean, they're on the attacking side, so they're gonna have a bit more trouble than usual. But it went from 5-1, from down to 6-5. So this is getting really close. And oh god, there he is, the menace. You know, upstairs in games, just patiently waiting for any misstep on Chilwagon so he can execute off of it as much as possible. And while there's no actual flank question, there's not a Nomad, there's not a Gridlock, but in my opinion, the best flank block would be a drone. And, oh, the Caveira pistol comes out, shotgun in hands, very close to where the Lion was previously, but he's going to be getting taken out as the man's advantage is on the side of Firebird. Will they be able to prevail and get themselves another chance for victory? The Huno getting taken out, and oh, what's happening? Oh,
why is a Caveira working? Not even what is happening. Why is a Caveira working?
I don't know.
And no, you are smarter than me. Answer. I don't know, is not an answer for a Caveira working in tier 4 against sub-diamonds and champs.
That's like asking me how a random wall tap one bank worked. I can't answer that. I'm not a genie nor a god. I'm just a man who casts Oregon way too much. Bomb located by attackers. That's who I am.
Who casts Oregon way too much.
Legend or not, it's still depressing.
No, I love you enough, mate.
Huh?
You still have an Oregon.
Yeah, thanks for reminding me.
I was like, I love you, chin up.
Oh.
Like, yeah.
Yeah.
That is a full drink, right?
So let's go back to the 30 seconds that we have remaining here. Shall we?
In 30 seconds, we will know if there will be an overtime line. As far as I can see, well, as of right now, there will be. Just judging by the standing, but oh,
10 seconds left.
But what is happening? It is all
over,
and it is.
Oh my god!
No.
Well, finishing off this second match of today, it's gonna be the one and only Chilwagon with an explosive finish onto the downstairs. The Caveira sadly could not prevail, but neither could Firebirds as they put up a good fight. You know, they went from 5-1 all the way to 7-5. A very good, I guess, difference they made up. And the kills were actually quite even. Lunar didn't do as well as he probably imagined, but still extreme. You know, the utility he put up there and the support was probably amazing. So, well played from both of the teams. And this match, well, it was interesting to see. Chilwagon definitely put up a performance, and so did Firebirds. I mean, they put up a counter-performance themselves as well. It was an interesting match, to say the least. I do believe it's going to be time for a good old 5-minute break. So before we sign out, stay tuned as it's about to get maybe even more exciting. We'll see.